What we have become accustomed to in terms of normal is rapidly coming to an end. The global monetary experiment is literally bursting at the seams. Carl Icahn, the 31st richest man in the world, has even came out and issued a warning and said that we have to worry about the excessive printing of money. Jamie Dimon, the CEO of JP Morgan, said there will be another crisis and its impact will be felt by the financial markets. Central banks have used the raising and lowering of interest rates for years to artificially control markets and their own interests. In extreme economic situations, like we are seeing now, more drastic measures have been taken, such as QE and other QE-type measures. Even the zero and negative interest rate policies, known as ZERP and NERP, respectively, was something historically unprecedented. As of December 16, 2015, the Fed made a move to raise interest rates by 25 basis points. This was a direct statement to the markets that they can raise rates and back off of zero if they want to. Of course, we believe this is a total bluff, and the stock market is and will continue to contract as a result of the rate hike. Maybe the Fed should have checked with consumers as confidence in November 2015 hit a 15-month low. This monetary experiment is over. The economy is more dependent now than ever on the circulation of increasing systemic leverage. How leveraged have things become? According to Bloomberg, in 2015, corporate America spent $3.7 trillion on mergers and acquisitions. This is more than any other time in history. Goldman Sachs estimates close to $1 trillion of the intangible asset known as goodwill, which is a premium paid when purchasing another company, has been added to corporate balance sheets since 2008. Economically sound investments are not being made, which will all show its ugly head when the crash occurs. Corporate productivity is seriously lagging, with investments in fixed assets being at their lowest level in 60 years. Corporate leverage is now at its highest level in a decade because cash flow is lagging the erroneous amount of malinvestments that are being made in the economy. If you want to hear some positive spin on the economy, listen to the president or the media, which report the BLS number, who says we are at a healthy 5% unemployment rate. Don't bother counting the roughly 100 million people who are capable and who to a large extent have quit looking for work. The labor force participation rate is just above 62%. To give Obama some credit, we've seen our fair share of growth in the service sector, with 1.4 million jobs created in the waiter/bartending job market since 2007. Unfortunately, real production happens in manufacturing, and we aren't seeing that whatsoever. Obama promised 1 million new manufacturing jobs by 2016, but we've been losing them. To be exact, 1.4 million manufacturing jobs have actually been lost since 2007. ISM manufacturing came out at the end of 2015, and we are seeing levels that we haven't seen since 08 and 09. Globally, things are coming to a screeching halt. One of the strongest measures for global strength is the Baltic Dry Index, which is a measure of the price of moving major commodities by sea, including coal, iron ore, and grain. This is hitting all-time lows. That does not indicate economic stability whatsoever. Countries around the world are seeing their currencies hit all-time lows, and central banks are resorting to extremes like negative interest rates to get people to spend and combat deflation. The stock market gains and the phony recovery being paraded by the mainstream media is over and will cascade into all areas of the economy. The Fed is damned if they do and damned if they don't at this point in terms of raising, lowering, or leaving as is the interest rates. The damage has been done and the consequences will be suffered. But let's just discuss one market that is far larger than the stock market and in some ways is already imploding and will continue to do so, and that is bonds. Now, for the last 35 years, bonds have been in a bull market, and this is quickly changing. A loss of faith in the dollar will be a loss of faith in credit. When perceived value of credit is lost, prices in the bond markets will collapse. Already, we are seeing bonds outside of government debt implode. According to S&P, U.S. junk bonds are seeing the highest distressed ratio since 2009. In the lower end credit spectrum, we are seeing yields spike as high as 17% with their underlying values plummeting. High yield bonds are a much clearer indicator of the true economy since it isn't being largely propped up by the Fed. Just like in the 2008 financial crisis in real estate, when we saw the subprime market collapse first and then followed the rest, so will we see here with junk bonds and the rest of the bond market as well. When interest rates rise, this will cause bond yields to rise and for bond values to plummet. With interest rates on the rise, we will likely see a major correction in stocks, which conventionally helps bonds. However, this time, we believe the next market crash will drain all confidence the world perceives in the credit markets and ultimately the fiat currencies. The markets will not react in a conventional manner after the chips settle. $19 trillion and counting is the official U.S. debt. The ability to service this increasing number is spiraling out of control. A simple 25 basis point rate hike will increase yearly spending by $475 million, and if they are able to raise the rate a full 1%, this will add an additional $190 billion, which is roughly half the current U.S. yearly deficit. Talking about the U.S. government bonds, the scenario is unsustainable. Either they default directly on the bonds and prices plummet, or they pay back the bonds with devalued hyperinflated currencies, which will both destroy the bond markets, where trillions of dollars of perceived wealth is being stored. Much of this wealth will vanish, with a portion of it being redirected to real money. Markets have been trying to deflate since 2008. The Fed inflating markets with low interest rates has created the largest asset bubble in history, which is going to pop. And we see this happening as soon as 2016. Be sure to have a healthy storage of precious metals, food, necessary supplies, and be sure you are carefully exposed to the financial markets as they pose great risks otherwise. Sign up for free at crushthestreet.com/future for our 2016 forecasts and predictions report that goes over our assessments for the coming 2016 year.